first of your baptism in the Premier League, Evo?
That was an exciting game, but obviously didn't finish the way we wanted. I didn't like our start. I thought we were slow to step out, gave them too much space, and that's a team that if you don't, in a strong way, close down some spaces, if you let them pull you around, you feel like there's always big spaces and they play through the lines. And so that part of the game I didn't like. And of course, that coincided with, from our end, two poor goals. But somewhere in there, I think we also started to play with more confidence. The tempo picked up. We started to close down a little bit more. We saw moments when we could press and win the ball higher. And then you get to 2-1 at half. That's pretty positive. So the halftime talk can be that in some ways we showed too much respect. But now you've shown that you can play it in this kind of match. Let's keep going. 3-1 from their end is a great goal. We were slow to push out. So certainly I can still see a part to that on our end that I didn't like. But again, I think we kept at it. So at the end, disappointed. But I think the feeling amongst the players is that we had a very good week of training. And that now if we can take the starting points that we saw today and keep going 30 more times, then there's a chance to become a really good team. And obviously, if you do that, you're going to take your points.
Was the pace of the game, the tempo of the game, when you're seeing it close, was it everything you expected? Or did the pace even catch you by surprise a little bit?
No, it's what I expected. You know, I haven't, of course, had the chance to be standing in that position for a Premier League game, but I've stood close to some other pretty good games, whether it's World Cup or Confederations Cup or whatever. So, you know, you get a taste of what it looks like when you're there. And there's players for Arsenal today that I've coached against, that kind of thing. So, you know, you have an idea what to expect. And again, and the difference between the top teams, the middle teams, the bottom teams is tempo. It's doing things quicker. It's closing down faster. It's the speed at which the ball can move. And so those are all things that we want to be about, but that's going to take the still work.
Bob, it seemed at the start that you were kind of looking around the stadium. Was that an attempt to calm yourself down? Was it to take in the moment, anything like that? Or was it purely and simply part of your routine?
Yeah, I like to come out and look around. I certainly it's not like I spend all day thinking about it, but there's it's a proud moment to walk out there today, for sure. But the other part of now knowing what happens when the whistle blows and what the game looks like, I've done that many times. So I don't get ahead of myself, but I was also trying to figure out the sections in the stadium, because over the years I've been able to look around and find my wife and my daughters, but I couldn't figure out what section was which, so I couldn't find them today.
What is the Bob Bradley brand of football? What is it going to be as far as Swansea is concerned?
I like a team that's good with the ball, that the spacing, the timing of moving forward is good, that when you lose the ball, the reactions to win it back are real, that, you know, it's complete football, that players enjoy playing that way and working to become better players, and that I'd like to think people enjoy watching that, but it takes a lot of work to become a good team.
And how do you think you've evolved since you started in MLS as a captain?
Oh, boy. I think my ideas on football have continued to grow. When you have a chance to work with, in different situations, players from different backgrounds. Over the years, I've had the opportunity to work with some real big players. I've worked with young players, and I think you've seen them grow and move up and do very well for themselves. So, you know, you take all those experiences, you put them together, your ability to handle situations, manage teams, manage tough moments. So I think you're a product of the experiences you have, and you keep trying to make yourself better.
Well, did you consider this something of a free hit? It's going to be a very different kind of pressure at home against Watford next weekend.
I never consider anything a free hit, but I certainly know that next week's game will be a very different kind of game. And, of course, at home there'll be more pressure, especially given the tough stretch that the team has gone through.
You got a message for the fans. They seemed to really be on the team in the second half there. Was it exciting to see them on your side, especially when you go into the draw later?
First of all, in the short time that I've been in Swansea, I know how special the Jack Army is, and how special the fans are, and the connection between the club and the community. And so to look into that part of the stadium today and see those people, I would expect that they're not satisfied, but maybe like me, they saw a few things today that say, all right, this thing is, we like what we see. So that doesn't mean that you get ahead of yourselves. The work to become a good team, no matter the league, is real. It's hard work. And you try to convince the players every day that the reason that most teams don't become good is because they're not capable of the kind of real work week in and week out to improve in so many areas. But I like this group. It's been really nice to come in and see their response. And there's not one of us that now walks out today feeling good. No chance. But I think, as I've said a few times, we can still look at some of what happened on the field today and say, all right, that's what we need to be about. You know, that's the kind of football we can play. That's the kind of mentality that we can build on. So it's a start. Yeah, whenever you go into work with any team, you try to establish with your players some starting points.
Was Barrow's performance on the positive
today? Yes, but I think he's just scratching the surface. My gosh, you know, this is a player with talent, but, you know, to try to get him in terms of his, you know, tactically, his timing is, you know, there are many times that I'm when he's on my side of the field that he can hear me. And so just in terms of, you know, when he goes inside, when does he stay inside, when does he back up again, you know, the kind of runs that he can make. So we worked at it in training this week. And I was pleased that you know, what I saw today was positive for sure. But now I already told him that I'm not going to be easier on you next week. This is just the start.